Hi all, let's discuss about IT project or about a software engineer. So in software engineering, what a software engineer does in and out day-to-day life. So before going into much details, I would like to highlight some key things. So one is database. So database is a key component of any project, I would say. You can talk about any application, let's say any commercial application, like you people are aware of, like Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, Twitter. So database is a key. So we are just posting something, but at the end, data is going to store in database. So that is this component. So as a symbol, we represent it like this. So this is database where data resides. Next component is applications. So basically, application is nothing but a software. So that we build, a software engineer builds, and testing engineers or test engineers, they perform testing for that application. So that is application, which is or which resides on a app server. This is nothing but app server. This is database server where database side application runs. Here all front end side application that will be deployed or installed and that will run. So number one, we have database. Number two, application. Okay. Number three, if you'll see, that is the UI or nothing but, maybe in your school and colleges, you people call it a GUI. So in IT industry, we call it UI.
It is graphical user interface.
Graphical user interface. But in a stylish way, we just call it user interface. Okay. There are various other interface also. You would have heard like CUI. CUI is nothing but character user interface. If you go to a railway counter, let's say, you would have noticed you are going to a railway counter, like conventional way or traditional way. When you go to railway counter, you ask for a ticket, and probably they give you a form that you have to fill. Then you submit it to the railway counter. Once you submit, then that person sitting behind that counter will use this application, which is nothing but CUI. You will see a black screen, looks like old days mainframe application. So that is a CUI application. And modern days, we have GUI or graphical user interface. Example, just go to your Android device or go to your laptop. You access Facebook, you access Twitter, you access Instagram, and so on. So these are the three important things that we work on. So maybe nowadays you are hearing a lot of other stuffs, like maybe you are hearing something like big data. So no need to be confused. Big data, small data, medium scale data, or whatever. So it is a data. So data means it has to go to database. So it's just the scale of the data. Data is really big. Data is really big means Amazon, let's say. They have data that is very big. So physically also they need to take data, they basically in some cargo trucks. So they ship the data. So data is really that huge. To store that in any device, it takes time. So data is that huge.
I have one doubt. For big data, do we use that same database to store the big data, or we need some different database?
Okay, so good question. Obviously, so I told database. So there comes size. Small data, big data, medium scale data. So if your data is huge, for example, my database is having a memory of, for example, 40 GB. So if it is a 40 GB database, how much data I can store in it? So basically 40 GB means, nowadays if you see one HD video I am storing, so basically one 10 minutes clip, it is taking around 1 GB, 2 GB. Whereas if I make a normal HD video, it is taking just 100 MB for a 10 minute video. So same is the concept. So if it is a small thing, normal data I can probably manage with 40 GB database. For example, I just need to maintain a small shop I'm just running a shop where I have, let's say, 2 to 3 lakhs of products that I want to sell. I want to have a warehouse. So that kind of data I can manage probably a 40 GB to 80 GB database. So that is a kind of small scale database. Then comes medium scale. Suppose 500 GB to 1 terabyte. Okay? But really big data exists.
It's 1 B or 1 TB.
1 TB. Terabyte. It's 1 terabyte. Okay? But terabyte is also not that huge when it comes to 100 years of data, 500 years of data, 1000 years of data, because some scientists, they need large scale data to analyze. For example, now let's say we are talking about a modern disease called corona. So corona, now it's a new thing. Probably we have a case of, let's say, 12 lakhs. So we just have a case of 12 lakhs infected patients. But day will come, maybe after, if we go down the line, this is just first year, year one. But when we come to year 50, obviously we would have come about around 1.3 billion people would have been infected. It doesn't mean I'm talking about all would have been died, but this is the probability. So you started with a journey, let's say, obviously it didn't start with 12 lakh, it would have started with 1. It's a really small data. So I can manage it with a database, small database. But over the period of time, maybe one data I can manage in my small smartphone also. But over the period of time, month by month data increased, and at the end of not even 50 years, maybe at the end of 5 years, I would have these many patients to manage, 1.3 billion. And you started with a country called China. So geographically also, it increased. China, then slowly it went to US, then Europe, okay, then India, finally it entered into India, let's say. So by the time we'll come to 5th year, it would have probably, this disease would have been spread in across all the countries, all the continents. So data will be 1.3 billion or maybe 10 billion. So 10 billion ten billion records or rows of information I have to manage. So obviously within a 40 gigabytes of database, I cannot manage. It's not just the patient. There will be several things. Country information. What are the countries? Then granular level, if you go, what are the states? India has many states. What are the states? Then what are the districts? So it's a chain. So when granular level you go, data becomes like a chain. So then you will have probably this 10 billion people, but they are making a data of 10 billion multiplied by maybe 5 times. So I'm talking about a 50 billion users, not users, 50 billion patients that they are generating different kinds of data. So what medicines they have taken, who is the doctor, who are the doctors they were appointed, and what is the hospital behind it. So these all are the data. So if you talk about this much data, then obviously it is going to be a big data. Today we started with a small data. So we don't need, because we are focusing on healthcare, other equipment, medicines, those are the primary thing. But over the period of time, when the death rate will be stabilized, and let's say newly infected patient rate will be stabilized, slowly we'll go to other aspects of it. Let's go to database, let's invest on IT. So slowly people will think, countries will start thinking of, let's have some information so that in future, if we go into, after 50 years if we go, we can study about this coronavirus. And let's say in future we got a virus called XYZ, what to do? In past, we have worked on a coronavirus case. In past, okay, today we are talking about, we have worked on plague, but probably because of unavailability of database or big data, we don't have adequate information. But now in this information era, when we have 50 billion kinds of data, varieties of data stored, then probably another term comes here, analytics. So this analytics is going to help to scientists, to astrologers, to any doctors, everyone, they can decide smartly. So that
at least they can predict. They can mitigate the risk also.
And this analytics is the area where lot of mathematicians also involved. they are deriving lot of formulas. Okay, this is the rate, I have this much hospital, so obviously I can not manage. If first year I am getting 1 lakh patients, obviously let's say 50,000 will die. But over a period of time, I would have made these many hospitals, these many doctors would have studied the case, so it's going to slow down. Okay, so we entered into more detailed study, but I thought of starting this session to limit this only with few key things, that is nothing but a database, application and a UI, user interface. So database, we know we need to store data. Application is nothing but the actually it's the business logic we call. This is where we put the business logic. Business logic or business rule. For example, one example about business rule. What kind of business rule we can put? For example, in Twitter, let's say, to register in Twitter, one must be above 18 years. So this is a business rule. That company or that organization, they have decided we won't allow any user to be registered less than 18 years. So this is a business rule. So this is just an example. You will have lot of business rules. So when you talk about business rules, you will have logic. So a study of logic. Logic is nothing but way, as a layman, I can tell if, then, else. If 18 years pass, else fail. So it has a branch. Above 18, pass. Less than 18, fail.
What about equal to 18?
Equal to 18 also, so it should be greater than equals to 18.
Okay.
So if your criteria business business or functional admin, they will tell no, I don't consider 18 also, I need above 18, so then I can tell greater than 18. Okay, so this is the logic. So for this kind of logic, we have a study. In 10th standard, you would have studied called flow diagram or flow charts. We represent it in flow charts. To represent it, we start with flow chart, then we write algorithms. This is nothing but step-by-step instruction we represent. Like step 1, start. Step 2, check this. Step 3, do this. Step 4, end. So that is algorithm, flowchart algorithm. These are nothing but, in software engineering we call them as design, low level design. Before this, we start with a high level design. High level design is nothing but a helicopter view. So for example, you can see, if I take you in a helicopter, you can see this, let's say currently I'm talking in a village. So you can see this entire village, where is the river, where is this building, where is the school, where is hospital. This is the high level design. So here, all the components we'll discuss in a high level. Facebook, there is a sign in, there is sign off, there is sign out. These are the high level components. Low level design, it is more detailing. Let's talk about only sign in. Don't talk about sign out and all the things. Let's talk about only sign in. Once you are done, go to sign out. Once you are done, go to register. So this is low level study. This is high level study. So flowchart algorithm I have covered. So after this, you go for coding. Coding is nothing but, in school colleges, we call it programming. You build some program. You build some application code. Then you test it. Once you test, pass it to user acceptance testing. So in next videos, we are going to discuss more about various things involved with testing. So just to start, this is a developer who is doing all these things, flowchart, algorithm, coding, programming. Then another thing, that is user interface. User interface is nothing but to build the page, how the page will look, what will be the background, color, what will be the theme, and how many text boxes will be needed, how many radio buttons will be needed. Radio button, for example, male, female, one user can be either a male or female, so it has to be radio button. Text field, there will be several drop down boxes. So this is nothing but user interface. There will be button like register. So this is the example of UI. So you will have jobs only about UI developers. You will have jobs only about application developers. You will have jobs only about this database developers.
So basically three types of software engineers are required in industry.
Required, but nowadays because of some more competition, sometimes few people are coming up with this combination known as, you would have heard this, full stack developer. Full stack developer is nothing but one person who is capable of handling all the three things, or even more UI. There are more components. There is in UI layer, you would have heard something like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, okay. Then you have ASP.NET from Microsoft product ASP. You have JSP from Sun Microsystem components. Okay, it's a scripting language. Application programming, I'd like to highlight here Java. Java comes here. C, C++, okay. C Sharp is again a Microsoft product. Java, it was initially Sun Microsoft product, now it is Oracle's product. Java is Oracle product. This is Oracle product, okay. And database, if you see, you will have bunch of players here. One is Oracle, you have Microsoft SQL Server. You have like MySQL. MySQL was Sun Microsystems product. Now it is part of Oracle only. So Oracle is having its proprietary database, which is Oracle. Now MySQL also coming under Oracle. Previously it was under Sun Microsystem, but now Oracle is having two databases.
So Oracle is the king of all databases.
We can say like that. They are doing business. What they have done, it's, for example, I started teaching, let's say, Oracle. You didn't like my teaching. You, let's say, like teaching of person X. So what I did, let's say I am a competitor. So I went and bought that guy. So that also came under me. So the same strategy Oracle has done. Oracle has bought around 50 databases. So 50 databases are under Oracle. And they have bought many ERPs. So they had their own ERPs, that is nothing but applications. Now they have their own applications. Let's say, for example, they
ERP, enterprises resource planning.
Resource planning. So they give option. You use our product. Let's say we have a product, PeopleSoft. PeopleSoft also, it doesn't belong to them. For example, Fusion. You use it. Customer said, sorry sir, I don't like your Fusion. I like PeopleSoft. It's another, okay. You like it? Okay. Take, you go and use it. After 1 year, you will see it is now Oracle has acquired it. Now PeopleSoft is also part of Oracle. Same thing happened. Many people were using Java. So people were diehard fan of this Java. But what Oracle has done, I think 2011 or 12, they acquired the Sun Microsystem. Entire company they acquired. As a result, they got a operating system, Solaris. Many people we know operating system like Windows, Linux and Unix, but Solaris is also based on Unix concepts. This is a very powerful operating system Oracle got from Sun Microsystem. This is all coming under Sun Microsystem. They got it. Solaris they got as a OS, as a database they got MySQL, and as a programming language they got Java. These all belong to Sun Microsystem initially. Okay. So finally, these all bunch of products or tools or whatever you call or programming languages, they become part of Oracle. But Microsoft remained to be a competitor. However, it is not that much popular nowadays. For small scale business, Microsoft is doing good. But Microsoft is having SQL Server database. Database name is SQL Server. Their programming platform is .NET. And UI component is ASP. So, I know, maybe for a school student or college student, this is plenty of things. But you can go through. If you have any doubts, you can reach out to me on the same number that is there in the description. And this is application. So, what we discussed? We discussed about the database. We discussed about application. We discussed about UI components. Okay, thank you.